lit by spasms of light.
You will recognize the two greatest Greek philosophers right in the center of the composition. The younger philosopher we see on the right side is Aristotle, with a book of ethics in his hands. We tend to forget that beyond being the father of science, Aristotle was the great teacher of Alexander the Great. On his left, recognize an old man. His name is Plato, but his features is the artist Leonardo da Vinci. Michelangelo is there writing as a loner he was, solitary, melancholic, sad, tormented, as the Greek dark philosopher Heraclitus. There's a lot of great figures who recognize me, a self-portrait of myself, and we'll see an old man, bald, who is using a compass, doing a geometric figure on the floor. This is Donato Bramante, but here, of course, he is Euclid. Plato has in his hand a book of Timaeus. This book is very important because it defines, in a certain way, with Ovid, Metamorphoses, and the Bible, of course, the origin of the word. Mathematics is a key to understand the physical complexity, infinity of the word. But more than that, Neoplatonism is very important in the late 15th and early 16th century. High Renaissance. Beauty inspires everything. The microcosm of human proportions, body, represent a macrocosm, echoes of the world where we are living. Nature, beauty should inspire us. Everything is proportions, goal numbers in architecture. What you see behind the Greek philosophers is the first project construction of the new Basilica of San Peter, started in April 1506 by His Holiness Julius II and his art advisor Bramante. The Parnassus, where the greatest poets used to live. You may recognize Apollo right in the center on the mountain, playing a very contemporary instrument, not at all antique one. You may recognize, of course, Dante Alighieri, the greatest poet of the medieval times, the father of modern Italian language, which was first a Tuscan dialect. And next to Dante, you recognize Homer, the great Greek master of epic poetry. In 1511, Bramante, who had the keys of the apartment, asked me if we were not curious to see what Michelangelo was doing since 2 years in the Sistine Chapel. And it had an extraordinary effect on my style. I was mesmerized by the extraordinary compositions Michelangelo painted, the strength, the poetic force, the unique, extraordinary way he was recreating. Doing frescoes, of course, gives me celebrity, fame, success, and I enjoy it very much. But looking to Michelangelo's extraordinary work, I couldn't resist now after Leonardo da Vinci to copy him. And that's why you will see more muscles, more masculinity, epic and violence figures. I try to do that in these compositions called The Fire in the Borgo. Borgo means a district, and what we see is a true story happening in medieval times. A pope with the same first name, Leon of Leon X Medici, if you want, who may recognize the features, is stopping with the power of prayer the destruction of a district of Rome. More than that, you recognize the way, organize the crowd escaping, the movement, the emotions. And I draw many cartoons going the same way for the life of maybe greatest story ever told, the life of Jesus Christ. The cartoons were sent to Flemish craftsmen. Flemish craftsmen have this great sense of details, almost maniac precisions, and I was sure that I could trust them to do the compositions right. I never saw finished in my lifetime the tapestries made by the Flemish artisans. But I trust, in a certain way, a great sense of colors using silver, gold. Look, the crowded hair, the eyes, clothes, details, hands. My last work before I died on Good Friday 1520, 6 April, was the Transfiguration, a mysterious, hermetic work in many ways, You can see the dark light contrast in painting, chiaroscuro, which was not my invention, but something I took to the great master Piero della Francesca. Go to Arezzo, see the frescoes of the story of the Great Cross, and look the frescoes Piero did of the dream of the Emperor Constantine before the battle he won. You will see the same chiaroscuro, dark light effect. On a point after the death of my great protector Donato Bramante in 1513, I was headmaster for the construction of the greatest project ever done for the Roman Catholic Church, construction of the Roman Catholic Basilica San Peter. I'm not an architect, but had many advisors helping me to do the right job. My obsession with the Pantheon, which is the greatest building ever surviving in the city center of Rome, was my source of inspiration. Bramante wanted to do a perfect square with a circle inside. The square represents earth, the circle represents sky, the Greek cross connects both elements, as the Roman Catholic Church does,